So the fight between SQL and NoSQL. A lot of you might have heard what SQL is. A lot of you, all of you might have heard what SQL is. So I'll give you a brief introduction about SQL and NoSQL is. I'll help you understand some concepts around it. And then I'll hope at the end of my talk, you get a clear picture what SQL and NoSQL is. And it helps you to make a right decision for which database architecture you should use in your next project. So my name is Harshil Agrawal. I'm basically a JavaScript developer. I'm a computer engineering undergrad at SVIT in India. I'm a GitHub campus expert and a DSC lead. Yeah, that's for me. So how I got into database? I started with front end. I came across Firebase. I really liked the concept about Firebase. So I read their documentation. I started building a few projects on that. And while reading the documentation, I came across NoSQL. I was very curious to know what NoSQL is because I had heard about SQL from MySQL and all that thing. So I started working on that. And then in college, I got introduced to SQL, where I learned more things about SQL. And then the questions came like, why there's so much difference between SQL and NoSQL, and which thing I should go for if I'm building my next project. So here's what I'm to talk about. So I talk about SQL. For most of the people, they think that SQL is a database, but it's not right. SQL is not a database. It is a query language. So a language which is used to query the data, that is retrieve the data, update the data, or even delete or insert the data. This is how a query for a SQL looks like. So select and from, they are the keywords in the command, and the asterisk and the products are the data parameters. So what this query does is, this query selects all the data that is present in the product table and gives you the output. So this is only the simplest query for SQL, but there are other commands also. There are commands to measure the data, delete the data, update, even create the table. So SQL stores the data in the form of tables. So tables are the database where all the content is present. And within those tables, we have fields. Now the most important thing about SQL is schema. SQL has a precise schema. So if you want to have a different field for a different record, that's not possible. You need to have the same field for all the records, or you cannot have the field for only one record. And the data in SQL is known as records. So this is an example of a product table where we have the fields called ID, name, price, and description. And then below that are the records for that. Now if I want to add a new record, let's say if I want to add pencil to this. So I do the simple insert query and I insert the record for this. But now if I want to have a new field for only the record pencil, like a short description, if I want to just add a short description to that record, that's not possible. Okay, so if I want to do that, I need to have the short description data for book and all the other records that I have in that particular data. So that was SQL. Now let's see what NoSQL is. So NoSQL basically it's not SQL. It's not relational. Okay, a database that is not relational and it stores data more flexibly than columns and rows is basically a NoSQL data. So NoSQL data has various types. These are the main four basic types of NoSQL data. That's graph store, key value, column store, and document database. So graph store data, if you are building the next Facebook, like a social media network, or if you have a roadmaps, or you want to have network topologies, then the graph store is best for you. And the example for that is Neo4j. Key value stores. It is the simplest form if you know about JSON, JavaScript Object Notion. It stores the value in the form of key and value. So that's what a key value, like that. It's similar to key value. And Redis is a very famous example for that. And if you have a large data set and if you want to do real-life analytics for that, and your data is unstructured, then you should go for column stores because it helps to optimize the query. And Cassandra is a very famous for that. And MongoDB, a lot of you might have heard MongoDB and you might have even used MongoDB. So MongoDB will see how MongoDB stores the data. So we'll see the database structure for that. So we have a database, and within those database we have collections. So we can compare collections with tables in SQL, and within those collections we have a document. The document are basically the records. So like if we have an example, so we have an example here. Shop is a database, and within that we have collections called products and orders, and within those we have different documents. So in product we have a document for book and something for pen and something like that. Even we can have a collection of users for this. So this is the structure of document. There is this name, price and description. Now if I want to have a new document, if I want to add pencil, now for pencil if I want to have a short description, it's okay, I can have a short description only for pencil and not for book. So that is how flexible NoSQL is. Yeah, this is query for NoSQL, db.products.find. The here products is the key, is the data parameter, while db and find are the keywords. So what this query does is it gives you all the data from the products table. Now yeah, before moving ahead, let's talk about scaling, because whenever we are building an application, we always come across scaling, like what type of scaling we'll need and when do we need the scaling. So let's understand what scalability actually means. Scalability actually means it refers to the capability of a system to handle the growing amount of work. So if a system is said to be scalable, if it can increase the workload and the throughput when the additional resources are added. There are basically two types of scaling. Vertical scaling. So vertical scaling is like adding resources to an existing system. Let's take an example, like there is a building. So adding more floors to the building, that's what that's kind of similar to vertical scaling. But vertical scaling comes with limitations. Like it becomes costly, because every time you need to buy a new hardware. And to configure that hardware, your system goes offline for a particular amount of time. So you lose your interest. Yeah. And then yeah, every machine has a limitations. Like a machine cannot be scaled up to after a certain limit. Like if we take an example of my machine. So I have an 8 GB RAM, but I can only scale it up to 16 GB. I cannot increase its processing power memory. Then there is horizontal scaling. Horizontal scaling is like adding more hardware to the existing system and not a particular server. So it's like adding more buildings to the neighborhood. The only limitation we face across horizontal scaling is splitting of data. So if you are using SQL, it becomes difficult to split the data, and that's why horizontal scaling is difficult for NoSQL. Now let's see why you should go with SQL. So schema, if you have structured data and you want to have a tight schema, then you should go with SQL. Relations, yeah. So if there are a lot of relations, like if you have a table for orders, if you have a table for products, and then you have a table of users. So you store only the particular information that you need. Like for orders, we'll store the product ID, the user ID, and the quantity. So what it does is, this also reduces the duplications. So yeah, and fast join. So if you want to join the tables, SQL provides fast joins. That was about SQL. Now, but why, if we want to go to NoSQL, why we should go with NoSQL? NoSQL provides scalability. It can have both vertical and horizontal scaling. There is a simple data model that you saw. There is also a dynamic schema. So you don't have to have a particular structure for the data. And low latency and high performance are the best features for NoSQL. Now let's see the examples, like which companies are using SQL and NoSQL. So this is booking.com. So booking.com uses MySQL. They use it for browsing, reservation, managing payments, analytics, and in the internal systems too. So what benefit they found out with SQL is that they use relational models. So it makes it very convenient for them and easy for them to run complex queries with SQL. Then there is Shravan. Shravan is a music streaming service. It's very popular in India. And they have a catalog spanning from more than 75 languages. They use MongoDB. They use MongoDB because it features like horizontal scaling, flexible schema, and high availability. This has helped them with tremendous growth. They store users' cohort, and then they send highly targeted push notifications. So this is why they go with NoSQL, because it helps them to do real-time data analysis. So still the question arises, what you should go for, SQL or NoSQL? Yeah. I don't want any of you to be like this. So you need to, before building your project, you need to ask yourself, like, do you have structured data? Do you need a clear schema? And do you use a lot of relations? If the answer for all these questions is yes, then you should go with SQL. But before going to that, you should also ask this question to yourself. Do you need to perform a lot of read and writes? Does scaling really matter to you? And do you need real-time analysis? And if the answer to all these questions is yes, then you should go with NoSQL. So let's have a quick overview. SQL has schema and NoSQL is schema-less. With SQL, you can have relations. With NoSQL, you can have like very few or no relations. SQL, it's very difficult to do horizontal scaling, but vertical scaling is possible. With NoSQL, both horizontal and vertical scaling is possible. And there are huge limitations for read and write queries per second with SQL. And like NoSQL provides great performance for thousands of read and write queries per second. That's it. Thank you. Questions?
You don't have any questions?
Can you give any example like which site we go for NoSQL? Because like NoSQL is the new like when number to SQL. So is there any like a use case for knowing the NoSQL?
I just gave the example of a shop, right?
Yeah, but you mentioned just the website.